5 minutes when he's going to give me a ring at the 4 minute mark. So I need to do it very quickly. You may have made tonight happen. Manny Haran's been unreal. He did the liaison with Wendell, and it was really great of Wendell to give his time to come up. And when he suggested Lauren, we couldn't be more happier. We're trying to promote things, not just footballers. We're trying to get especially someone with Lauren's achievements. It's fantastic what she's done. You know, I haven't achieved half the stuff she has. Yeah. And everyone else who made the night down to the people at the door, Steve, Bobo, the Workman's Club, and Casey's been unreal. That's Brock's girlfriend, so we know who will run the show when they get married. It won't be Brock, it'll be Casey. Okay, just quick. Obviously, the women, you know, another announcement. All the women are over in that corner. The whole football team's up here tonight. Well done to you, women. She will make a guest appearance in the women's team next year. We're going over here, so we should get a couple of...
Hey, some guys are in a small place.
Anyone was to sleep in, miss a session, we'd all do the penalties together. And we all bought into it. We said, yeah, sweet. So we're thinking maybe an extra 20-minute session, you know, after Dragon's Train or something. But one morning about 5 in the morning, it was pissing down rain here. And they said, you have to go to Helensburgh. And I thought, well, I've heard of Helensburgh, but where's Helensburgh, you know? I knew where Shell Harbour was because I put that place on the map. But, and that's even the best part of that. I used to set up a lot of tries. I don't think anyone recognises it. So I knew I was going real shit when Gold Coast Seagulls brushed me. So I'm often a sort of person, not overly cocky.
Nah.
And as I walked into the development office, there was Brett Wadwell, who I was a massive fan of, and Paul McGregor. And I walked in, and I used to be a centre fullback, and I walked in and I said, which one of you guys are playing on the wing next year? Because I'll be playing the centre. So, big guy at the end there, taking his shirt off me.
Guy, you're that
way. I hate those sort of blokes, they really annoy me, those sort of blokes. I'm looking at specimen, but anyway.
How long is it? First, I've heard you say that here about stats. At that stage, you know, you were one of the biggest sporting identities in the country.
No, I was.
You were the biggest.
I felt like a rock star until that $1 million contract got retired.
I think that's probably about the same language for even odds on this.
And then Wayne called me that day. And we had this real good bond. And I would a person like you need to take drugs. I said, what do you mean? He goes, you're stupid enough without taking drugs. So, for me, he understood the kidnapper.
No, we appreciate your honesty and your deal. It's always something, you know, you pay your life. Personality, so we're going to have you back up here again, ladies and gentlemen, later on, interviewing Lauren Angus.
At the moment,
and they're happy to wait. It's such a
smiling sweetheart. She's a professional, and I think her and her father know not to do things that are absolutely ridiculous, but you know, she's on the edge.
All the races and got involved in skiing and competed at a world level and ended up becoming world champion in water skiing. And then unfortunately, my dad passed away in 2008 in a boating accident on the harbour. I took it pretty hard because he was my mentor and I really looked up to him. I was heavily involved in sports all my life, really, throughout school. And then I guess I quit skiing, not because I wanted to, but just out of respect, I thought it was the best thing to do. And my first fight about 5 months later, and I love it. I've fallen in love with the sport. It's sort of been a bit of a coping mechanism for me, for my dad, and I've loved it.
You look all right. You look all right, you know, and you don't want a job. But also, you're studying as well, studying journalism.
Yeah, I am. I'm studying journalism. I love to influence and inspire other people. And I hope, I've just started up this program called Girls Grab Gloves and trying to implement, I guess, a program that educates young kids on, nutrition and also implements compulsory physical activity. So I'm working on that at the moment and I hope that goes well.
That's great. Well, we've always, is it true that you could be making a guest appearance for Helensburgh Tigers?
Actually, you know what? I'm not that. Sorry.
How do you feel about being the hooker for the Helensburgh?
Hey, female athletes here tonight with us, giving such an honest account of their sporting achievements and their life as well. So, thanks so much, Lauren, for coming along tonight. We're going to invite our auctioneer, local auctioneer, up on the stage, Ronnie Kinsel, because we've got four major.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, can I get a photo with Warren? Bit of 500 there. At 500, we've got 550, I'll look more now, 550, no, straight back at 600, sir, 600, 900, we've got there, 950, straight back, 951, 1,050, you just come up with
it's just video, guys, so say whatever you want. You got it right, though. You're going good.
Local comedian, Shane Young.
Hey, can we get some more plants on stage, please? More plants? I don't think 8 plants is enough. I want to consolidate the fact that I look like a drug dealer. See the equestrian dressage, you seen that shit? Yeah, that's really interesting. It's the horse just parading around on the fucking squares. Yeah, it's like Dell on the big screen, isn't it? Look at me, I'm a fucking printing horse. Yeah, you say, mate, run faster. That's all I got. Roger Federer, arguably the greatest tennis player of all time, as a coach. What are you going to tell Roger Federer? Roger, mate, your backhand is shit, mate. It's just shit. And Roger's like, have you won 17 grand slams? A tattoo of his mum's name. And I was like, why? Are you going to forget? Because to me, getting it in mountain guys, and yeah, mate, I just want to get a tattoo of your mum's name. Oh yeah, what's her name? Fucking Shazla. I've never been to Mount Druitt. Mount Druitt could be a lovely place. New weekend, it's a fucking shit. It just sounds like a shit. If you listen to your car stereo and you're not in the car, you're a fucking cool. Bad breakup too, she stole my heart and in return I stole her car. Made things interesting, but she said, be careful when someone says to you, you look good enough to eat, they mean it. You know why? Because you look like a tandoori chicken. And they are probably hungry. Thank you very much.